Good morning, dear children. I'm Ms. Bhavna here again for another session of English. I hope everyone is taking care of yourself and all are looking hale and hearty. And during this lockdown, you are using this time judiciously. And moreover, you are also revising whatever has been done in the online session and whatever has been done in our previous class. So to recapitulate, I will ask few questions which are based on the topics which I have covered in my previous class. So in the last topic, I have done conjunctions. So I will start with asking few questions from you all. I hope you're ready with a pen and a notepad, and check your posture, everyone. All right, let's start. So my first question is, what are conjunctions? What are conjunctions? This topic I have taken earlier. So conjunctions are joining words. We can call it in three ways. Conjunctions are joining words. They are also called as linking words, or they are called as connectors. They are used to join two words, or they are used to join two sentences. Name the basic conjunctions. The basic conjunctions means the conjunctions which we use in our day-to-day life. As I told earlier, the basic conjunctions are and, or, but, so, neither, nor, either, or, if, unless. All these are basic conjunctions which we use in our daily communication. What are the three ways through which we can understand conjunctions? Now, what are the three ways I taught you through which you can understand conjunction? The first is coordinating conjunction. Second is subordinating conjunction. And third is correlative conjunction. Why conjunctions are important in English language? Conjunctions are important in English language to join sentences and write in a smooth manner. To write a report, to write a summary, to write a story or do anything. If you want to write anything, we should have the knowledge of writing conjunctions. So this was done in our previous class. What are we going to do today? Today we are going to do email writing. We are going to learn how we can write email to our friends or to any organization. We have already done formal letter writing and informal letter writing in class 6th. Yes, so this email writing follows the same pattern. Informal email writing will follow the pattern of informal letter writing, and formal email writing will follow the pattern of formal letter writing. Okay, now in this session, I'm going to cover what is email writing, format of email writing, examples and types of email writing. What is an email? Now I'm telling you so many times, you are going to learn email, email. What is this? E stands for electronic. The term electronic, electronic mail. So we can either write e-mail or email. E-mail or email, it's one of the same thing. It is a method of exchanging messages that are mail between people using electronic devices. So it is a method to exchange your messages or to exchange mails or letters. Okay, so children, in this age of technology, the email has become the easiest and the fastest mode of communication. It is used to send letters or messages using what? Now we are talking through which medium? Through internet, okay? Emails are easy to use and they can reach the person to whom you're sending in fraction of seconds. It is the cheapest source of communication and it is good to follow this pattern rather than writing on paper, then posting it, then it will again take 2-3 days to reach to the person to whom we are sending. So it is the easiest and the most convenient way to send. What does this symbol stand for? Now what is this? You have seen it several times. Yes, it is used on the internet while writing email. It is used for writing our email IDs, email address. Every person is having a unique email ID or unique email address through which he or she is sending and receiving mails. This act is very important. Now, we can call it in three ways. We can call it as at the rate of, we can call it as at sign, or we can call it as address sign. So what are the three things? At the rate of, at sign, thirdly, address sign. Now, this is the symbol of email address. It separates. It separates what? The name of the user and the address of the user. Okay, so it separates two things, the name of the user and the address of the user. How it separates? For example, if my email ID is bhavna123@gmail.com. So my name is bhavna123 and what is my ID? Gmail. So how it is separating my name with the ID? This is very important. If you are writing an email ID, this is very important aspect. All right, our next slide. These are the types of email service providers. They are Gmail, Yahoo, MobileMe, AOL, Microsoft Exchange. So you can use any of the service provider to create an email ID. Now, various types of email IDs I'm having over here. These are all imaginary email IDs. See, you can create an email ID by using your name and the numbers. See, you can see it is alphanumeric. Alphanumeric means what? Alphabets plus numbers. So we call it alphanumeric. So email ID is always created alphanumeric. So for example, riyakumar123@gmail.com, rohan22sharma@yahoo.com, alicejones2012@yahoo.co.in, and the last one is the professional ID. Professional, or you can say formal email ID, which is having the name of the organization. This is our school email ID, manavds@gmail.com. So first three are informal email IDs and the last one is formal because it is carrying the name of any organization. So children, you can also create an email ID by using your name and using your birth date or any important day of your life. You can use it and create a very short, simple email ID. And after the session, I will request you to create an ID so that you exchange emails with your friends. You can share an informal email by writing them what all things you are doing during lockdown. Now, what is the difference between email and postal mail? Postal mail means which you write on a paper and you post it in a post box and then the person receives it after 3-4 days. So electronic mails or emails are not like postal mail. They are similar. They are following the same pattern of writing with the minute difference, but still they are different. Email saves trees by reducing the usage of paper while a postal mail uses paper. So this is how, by using email, we can reduce the usage of paper and hence we can save trees also. Postal mail needs stamps while emails do not need stamps. So why it takes a longer time for the person to receive the mail? Because first we are going to post it in a post box, then it will go to the post office, there it will be stamped, then the postman will deliver. It will take a very long time, and we in such a fast life, we can't wait this much. So email will go in a fraction of seconds. We can also send videos and music through emails while we cannot buy mails. So through emails, we can send any video. If suppose you cooked something special for your family and you want to show it to us or to anyone, you would just have to, you can post the videos, you can share the music, you can share your pics on emails, which it is difficult to do it on postal mails. Steps to create an email ID. This is a very important step. So how will you create an email ID? I know most of you are having email IDs, but some of you might not be having it. So I will teach you how to create an email ID. See, first of all, you have to visit a website that offers an email service, and that offers, you can either visit gmail.com or you can go to yahoomail.com. You are going to see the web page. See, point number two, find where to sign in. Usually there is a small link, image or text that say register or create email account. Now, once the page is open, there you are going to find this term register, or you can find this mail, find this term create email account. You go to this link and create your email, click on create email account. After clicking on email account, you'll get one more page where it is asking so many questions about yourself, like your name, full name, your gender, your date of birth, and all those questions which are very general. You are going to fill all those, fill that page, and then you are going to click get started. See point number four, click in get started. Once you have filled all the information, click on get started. It will ask you to generate a password. You can create any password, you can give anyone's name or any organization's name, any password of your choice you will create. So this is how you're going to create an email ID. You are going to make it alphanumeric at, for example, bhavna123@yahoomail.com or bhavna123@gmail.com. And then you're required to type a password of your choice, verify the password once again, and this is how your email ID will be created. Now, once your email ID is created, how to use it? Now visit the web page again, for example, mail.yahoo.com, and click on sign in. See point number five here. Click on sign in. Press the button. You are going to enter your home page. This is your home page. Here you can see many options. If you want to check if somebody has sent you any mail, you are going to click on inbox. Once you click on inbox, all the emails which you have received in your mailbox, you are going to open them and you can check. And if you want to compose a mail, compose means to write a mail. So what you're going to do, see point number eight, click to compose button to create new message. So here you're going to click it and a new window will pop up where you're going to enter your message by writing the email IDs and the message. When you click on compose button, you get new window where you can send a mail. Right top of the screen, click to sign out to go to Yahoo homepage. Now, once everything is done, once you have composed the mail, once you have checked your emails, everything, now you want to come out of your homepage. So you have to, don't forget, you have to click on sign out and then you're out of your homepage. So now you have learned how to create an email ID. You have learned how to check your emails. You know where you can write email, but still, you know how to write an email, which I'm going to teach you in my next slide. Here, before learning that, the types of email messages we have, emails, just like letter writing, they are also of two types. One is formal email writing, one is informal email writing, as we have done in class six. Formal means when you write to companies, government departments, offices, and informal means family, relatives, friends. In the same manner you wrote formal letter writing, formal letters you give to companies, government offices, and any person who don't know you personally. And informal, when you write to someone who knows you personally, like your grandparents, parents, family members, relatives, neighbors. Okay? Difference between formal and informal. Formal, when you write to school principal or teacher, office or companies, government departments. Informal, just now I told you, family, friends, and relatives. Now, when you are writing formal email, you have to use professional email ID. If you're writing to any organization, name of the organization @gmail.com. They must be having a specific email ID which is based on the name of their organization. But when you use an informal, it will be based on a person's name. Subject is very important, informal and informal both. Why? Because when we read and the person is reading the email, he should know what is the context of the email. And the subject should be very short, should be very simple and very crisp. It should not be very long, it should not be vogue, you should not write a complete story over there. So it should be of not more than 3-4 words, but it should be specific. Use professional font. Yes, if you write, sometimes you write very big fonts, or sometimes you write very small, it is not good. Informal email, same font style should be followed. No emoticons, no colorful text, no design, nothing. You don't have to ornate it. You don't have to make any designs. Whereas in informal, you can use colored fonts, you can use emoticons, you can use any type of big or small fonts of your choice. always include a closing statement. What is the purpose? And the closure should be perfect and formal. Letter writing, that why you are writing this, introduction of yourself should be there, and the purpose of writing should be there. Whereas in informal, you can begin with hi and hello, and you can immediately come to the point. Format of email writing, children, please take a screenshot of it, or you can write it down. Take a notepad, draw a big rectangular box on top, draw three lines. The first thing should be from. From means who is writing this email. For example, if I am writing the email, this email is from my side. So I will write my email ID over here. If you are writing email, you are going to write your email. Then to whom you are sending. If suppose I'm writing this email to Karishma over here, okay? Yes, Karishma, if I'm writing this email to you, then I'm going to write your email ID into, okay? CC, the full form of CC is carbon copy. It means that if I, apart from Karishma, I want others also to see this. For example, if I'm writing this email to Devanshi as well. Now Devanshi's email ID will be written in CC, so she can also see this email once I click on send. Next option I have is BCC, blind carbon copy. It means that if suppose I'm sending this email to the third person, apart from Karishma, apart from Devanshi, I'm sending this to suppose Arna. Now Arna's email ID, I'll be writing it here. I know that I have sent this email to Arna. Arna knows it because he has received it. But Karishma and Devanshi will not come to know that I have also sent this email to Arna, because this is blind. We cannot see to whom I have written. Children, CC and BCC is not mandatory to write. In place of CC and BCC, you can write date if you want. Make one column of date and you can write. So you can write from, to, date, and subject. If you write this, I'm not going to deduct marks. It is correct. If you don't write this, still your marks will not be. Next is very important aspect of email writing, that is the subject. The subject, title, or the reason of writing email. Why are you writing this email? The title should be very crisp, very short, sweet, and simple. Not beyond 4 or 5 words. You're not going to write complete statement, story over here. It should not be book. Salutation means hi, hello, this, or dear. If you're writing a formal email, you're going to write dear sir, or dear ma'am. If you know the name of the person, for example, you can write dear Mr. last name. Okay. Then comes the main body of email. Main body is again divided into 3 sections, as we have done in formal letter writing and informal letter writing. Here we are going to follow the same pattern. First, I'll take the example of formal. In formal email writing, the main body or the main content of the letter is divided into 3 sections. In the first section, you are going to write the introduction. You have written, dear sir, then you are going to write introduction. Introduce about yourself. That person doesn't know you personally. Who you are? Who is writing this email? He doesn't know you. So you have to introduce yourself by writing, I am, for example, if I give my name, I am Bhavna Tandar, a resident of so-and-so society. Then write the purpose of writing the email in the first paragraph itself. I am writing this email because I want to share my concern regarding dash, whatever. Okay. So in the first paragraph, I have included two things. Repeat with me. First is the introduction of your introduction. Second is your purpose of writing this email. I am writing this email because to share my concern, or if you have any doubt, if you want to complain, whatever. Then comes the matter in detail. The second paragraph comes the matter in detail. Here you are going to elaborate your concern, your complaint, or your doubt, or your query. You have to elaborate more about it in the second paragraph. Then comes the conclusion. What you expect from the reader to do. What means, what do you expect him to do? What you want him to do? What is the need for writing this email? What result you are expecting? What outcome you are expecting? That you have to write it in the conclusion. Ending statement, one line. In the ending, you have to add, please respond on the same email ID as soon as possible. I'll be waiting for your reply eagerly. I hope you'll be doing the needful. You can end it like this. Okay. In formal email writing, you are not going to use any sort of abbreviation. Abbreviation means short form. You're not going to use any abbreviation. You're not going to use any short forms or slangs. The way you chat on WhatsApp, the way you chat on other social websites, you're not going to use those slangs. For you, you have to write Y-O-U. You can't write you. No, it will not be accepted. Then comes attachment. If you want to attach any file or folder here, you can do that, but it's not mandatory. Because if you attach, your file become, your email might become heavy. It's not mandatory in exam. Also, if you don't write this, your marks will not be attached. Next comes the signature line. Signature line means the ending line, sender's name, signature. Children, whenever you're writing a formal email, you will write three things you can write at the end. First, yours sincerely, full name. For example, if Tanmay Gupta is writing this email, Tanmay Gupta, not just Tanmay, full name. Second way, first you have the written regards, sorry, yours sincerely. Second, yours faithfully you can write. And thirdly, you can also write just regards Tanmay Gupta. Okay, so three things, yours sincerely or yours faithfully or regards or with regards, both are correct. And at the end, you can add your contact number, you can write imaginary. It will be fine. So this is how you're going to write a formal email, the body, main body of formal email. Let's come to informal now. Informal is also divided into three parts. The main body is divided into three parts. First, the introduction. You can start by greeting, hello, exclamation mark, how are you? I hope you're doing well, your exams, I think you're promoted to the next class, how is your experience? Then if suppose you're going to write about the lockdown situation, the, like how you're, what hobbies you are indulging in nowadays, what things you are doing nowadays, any change in your routine, your schedule. So if you suppose you're going to write to your friend about all these things, so how will you start? You're going to write, hello, how are you? I hope you're fine and your family is doing well. And then you write the purpose also. I'm writing this letter to share my experience during the lockdown period. So again, main body, first paragraph, two things. First is greeting and then purpose of writing. Then comes the matter in detail in second paragraph. Elaborate what you're doing. Ask what he is doing. Mention everything, how you are utilizing this time, whatever. Then comes the conclusion, what do you want, what do you expect the other person to do? You can write, I hope you will write to me soon, I'll be eagerly waiting for your response. And you can conclude by doing this. In the signature line, you are not going to write yours sincerely, you are not going to write yours faithfully, because we are using these two terms in formal letter writing. In informal letter writing, you are going to use yours truly, or yours affectionately, or yours lovingly. Okay, so if you're writing to your grandma, what will you write? Yours lovingly. And then you can write only your first name. Full name is not mandatory. You can even write your nickname, because you're writing to your friend, you're writing to a relative, so they know you personally, so you can write it. And when you write it on top, the salutation, you will not write dear friend. No, you know the name of your friend, so you will mention dear and then name of the friend. So this is how we write informal. I have told you both formal, how it is to be written, and informal. And you must have taken the screenshot of this page also. Let me hop to the next one. Here again, there is a format of writing email. You can see from, you can see how it is written, sender, the ID, person's name, @, the name of the email ID. Receiver, @, the name of the email ID. This is just an example. Then instead of writing CC, BCC, I told you, you can even write date. Then comes the subject, whatever your subject is, whatever the content is about. Then you will write salutation, dear sir, or dear ma'am, or dear your friend's name, or dear grandma, or dear mom, whatever. Then informal email writing, this is very important. Body of the email must contain complete sentences. You can't write incomplete sentences. Each topic should be told or asked a new paragraph. Wherever you want to talk something new, you have to generate a new paragraph to use that. And be more careful to use these two terms, please and kindly. Be very humble in formal letter writing. And then in the end, regards and your full name, along with, if you want to add contact number, you can. Now, points to remember, write a meaningful subject line. What is the subject line? Just now I told you this is especially important for writing formal emails. You are going to write the subject to sum up the body of the email. Keep the message focused and readable. What do you mean by this? If there are various issues to be presented in an email, formal email, what you are going to do, you are going to ensure that you are going to present it neatly, label it and beautifully, like 5 points you want to have. Share, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It should be neatly presented. Keep the message short, very short. Don't write 2, 3 page stories over here. Avoid attachment as far as possible. I gave you the reason why, because it becomes very heavy. Avoid using fancy typefaces. Now, typefaces means designs. Don't ornate it. Don't design it and capitalize the whole text. No, you should not capitalize. A same font should be used. Sign off appropriately. Sign off appropriately means when you write in the end, regards with your full name. Proofread the letter for language and restrain before hitting the send key. Now, proofread means go through what you have written, find out if you have made any grammatical error or any other sentence formation should be correct or any other error you have made before hitting send. Because if you will click on send, your email will go. Now, this is again the format, informal format. Saying, dear father, how are you? I'm going to Kolkata for 15 days in the month of May for an urgent work of the company. So I will not be able to come home as planned earlier. However, I will come home after I return from Kolkata. So this is written to a father. It is very informal. Nothing formal over here. I miss you all. Yours lovingly, Sohan. So only the first name has been written in the end because it is informal. Professionally, emails, guidelines, I told you, subject line should be concise. It should be very short, not very long. Greeting should be avoided. It can be there. Font style, no decoration, no ornating, no playful words, no color fonts. Font should be same. Length should be concise, not very long, simple, short. Emoticons should be completely avoided and check the spelling and the grammatical errors. Now this is the formal email. Look at the first part. I recently purchased a brand new 32 inches LCD color. Now this is see the subject, faulty TV set. After reading this line, you'll come to know what is the email about. So you come to know that this TV set which has been purchased from the shop is not functioning. It is malfunctioning. Obviously it is a complaint letter. Look at the ending. My several reminders have not changed the situation. Hope you will understand the plight and get the set replaced with the earliest and live up to your organization's image. So this is the conclusion. This is what you expect from the reader to do. This is how you're going to make conclusion. Here it is the example of informal email writing. Here you can see how the subject is written, my family. Now you come to know it is informal. Someone is writing about his or her own family. How are you? I hope you're well. Thanks for your last mail. So it is starting with a very positive note. Look at the ending, the last line. Well, that's all for now. I hope to hear from you soon. So it's very nice. What do you expect the readers to do? That they also write you. I'm going to play a very interesting, informative video over here. So kindly pay attention and listen carefully.
For the past few decades, email has been a cornerstone of business communication. And over that time, it's developed a unique style and structure. All business emails should be direct, clear, and easy to read. The formality of your writing, however, can vary depending on your company, your readers, subject matter, or other factors. No matter what you're writing, remember to stay professional, because you lose control of an email once you click send. Emails can be copied and forwarded to others indefinitely, so make sure you choose your words carefully. When it comes to the subject line, you want it to be brief and descriptive. If it's too vague or rambling, you may lose your reader's attention. Every email needs at least one recipient. But if you're including multiple recipients, consider using the CC or carbon copy field. This keeps those extra readers in the loop without requiring them to respond. Make your greeting brief and friendly, and address the recipient by name if you know it. The first name is preferable if you're more familiar with the recipient, and you should use their last name if you want to be more formal. In the body of your email, start with your main point so it's easy to find, and keep your writing concise and focused on your readers. If you need a response from your readers, include a call to action so they know how to respond. Also, if you've attached a file to your email, be sure to mention it here. As you reach the ending, offer a quick farewell, such as thanks or sincerely. Then give your name and contact information. Writing concise emails is a powerful skill that you can develop through consistent practice. Keep writing and learning, and you'll become a more effective communicator with every email you send. For the past few decades, email...
This was very informative. I hope you have gained enough knowledge regarding how to write an email. Let me recapitulate once again. Then the first line, you can see the address you are going to write. You have to write the email IDs. You can send for more than one recipient. If you are having many recipients, you can write it in CC or BCC. Then you have to write the subject line. You can even mention one column of date over here. Then the subject, whatever the topic is related to, then the main body, the opening line, then the main body, which is divided into three parts: introduction, purpose, elaboration of purpose, and conclusion, and then the signature. This we have already done. This is the follow-up question. You have to write two questions. The first is write the format of an email. How will you do it? You'll make a big box. You divide into three sections. The fourth one should be big. Here you are going to write on top from, then to, then date, and the subject. These terms you have to write, which I'm saying right now. From, to, date, subject. And then you are going to write salutation. Then you are going to write body. Then you are going to make three bullets. You have what you are going to write in main body. And main body you are going to divide into three. The first one, introduction and purpose. Second one, elaboration of purpose. Third one, conclusion. Then you will write closure line. And then signature, and you will also make the tab for send so that it appears as if this is a complete email box. The second question is write an email to thank your grandpa for the fascinating storybooks by Roald Dahl he sent you on your birthday. So your grandpa has sent you a box of a set of Roald Dahl books. Also tell him how you love the movie Charlie and Chocolate Factory based on the same author's book. And that now you would like to read that book too. So you also watched a movie, Charlie and Chocolate Factory, which is based on Roald Dahl's book. And you have watched it and you want to appreciate that also, that you are going to read the same book, which is written by Roald Dahl. And how you enjoyed it, you are going to write an email. So what type of email is this, formal or informal? Yes, it is informal email. So these two questions we have to do, not on email, on a sheet of paper or on a notebook, which you are maintaining these days. And all your doubts will be cleared. Yes, you have to do it on a sheet of paper. If you have any doubt, do it. I will be asking the questions related to the email writing, what we have done today in our next class. And our next class will be of lesson one. I'm going to start with a new lesson of Magic Lamps and Genius. Do revise what has been done in the online session, practice at home, and take care of your health. Thank you. I hope you have understood what has been discussed today. Please give the feedback on the chat. It will be appreciated. Thank you so much, children. Have a good day.